Okay, today we assemble the mirror cell. It's a 27 point mirror cell, meaning that there are 27 points that are touching the back of the mirror, and these points are actually pads made out of Delrin, and these little pads, 27 of them, they're gonna be on each corner of these triangles. They fit, yeah, pretty much. This leg a little bit, and three of these are going to be hinge on this bigger bracket, bigger triangle, and each of these three is going to be on top of this. All of the hinges are ball bearing, Teflon ball bearing, or spherical bearing actually. So this is in order that the 27 points are carrying exactly the same weight, pretty much the same weight from the mirror. Hence they are optimizing the formation of the mirror itself. Then we have two little trees, four contact points in total, that is for the lateral support of the mirror. Let's start with finishing up a couple of these components. Like this one needs 8 millimeter holes and 5 tapping, so that we can put these spherical joint, as you see. Yes, and we need to finish up the assembly of the main three bearings. Sorry, main three triangles with bearings. How do we assemble a triangle? Okay, the first thing that we need to put in is the spherical bearing. Here it is. And there's a stainless steel M5 screw to hold that. It's going to protrude a little bit, and we need to avoid that with some washers, as the distance between this surface and the back of the mirror is going to be just the thickness of this Delrin pad. So it's going to be a couple of millimeters. I'm going to use three washers in total, a couple on the back. Like this bearing, and one between the bearing and the triangle. You can just and tight it in place and just nice tighten it. No, it doesn't need to be overstressed. Right, then top of that, on the other side, we just pop in the pads. 1, 2, and 3. And we just need to have 9 triangle like this. We're gonna take care of a little bit of excess of plastic here, but it's enough. So the back of the mirror is gonna rest on this triangle, just like the remaining 8. So we're done with the first three. There are effectively two different shapes of the smaller aluminium triangle. This is the first one, and there are six that are a different shape for the other side. And then we have the three big steel one. Let's get on with the other one. Again, we used three washers, two on one side. The reason why I put two on one side would be more obvious later is pretty much given the fact that the clearance here, and I don't want to have the aluminium triangle protruding too much for metal torque in the overall assembly. I'm gonna keep the overall cell as low as possible. Every millimeter counts. Squeeze. There we go. More on the other side. This flash, see, I'm gonna drop in the pads. Some are easier and some are not. Fix them up. And one is done. Let's get on with that at 7. Alright, so next step is we're going to assemble the main triangles on the frame. Again, the triangles are going to be able to hinge on a spherical bearing. Get on with that. Goes in here. The bearings are secure in place just by gravity. Because the sound doesn't go upside down. Secondary triangle on in a range that our supposed to be in the mirror cell, which I think it is something like that. And then we have this one in here. Let's see if it slots. Okay, wait just a minute to find the right alignment. Thank you.
is how the cell looks like. Like that. And we'll just try and open the mirror. Right, we are ready to put the mirror on top of the cell. I rearrange the triangles as they are coming out of plot, the famous freeware to calculate the and optimize the cell. So there are another couple of optimization that I made in the meantime. Let's see how does it look like.